Dispenser going up.
Well, I guess that'll do.
Hey, everybody, Uncle Dean. A little bit of a live commentary here. Other than just playing on snowplow or snowy coast, I always call it snowplow on accident. At least the first time. You can see. I don't know if you can notice, but my animations are a little different than normal. Like when I reload, especially. Like for instance, I'm gonna frag these guys over here. Ooh. And when you, like, take them out and stuff, I sort of feel bad about doing that to people, but a short circuit's just so much fun sometimes. Oh, come back, Scout, I only did 15 damage to you. Anyway, the animations are a little different. I like the Gunslinger one the most. This is an SV Pure modification that you can have. Doesn't look like we're gonna... we're almost at here, so... But that's okay. You just gotta do this, and they won't even notice, except for that guy will. Anyway, we're getting a little distracted with the main point of the video, which is just basically to show off two things. I like what they did with the snowplow changes, which they did like 3 months ago, 6 months ago, too long ago. And I also wanted to show you guys these animations, because they're pretty cool. I don't know if you guys know this about me, but generally when it comes to video games, all sorts of video games that have modifications enabled for them, I typically prefer going for the vanilla type thing. In TF2, the only really different kind of thing that I have is my HUD. So this is kind of a step in the unfamiliar direction for me, since I don't normally go for this kind of thing. But I looked at the video and I looked at how easy it is to install, and I decided to try it out. And you know what? I've been using these for a couple days now. I'm very, very happy with them. I don't think I'm going to be able to go back. I can show you guys some of the other ones. The wrench one is pretty nice when he takes it out. You know, he's got one hand on it. And one of my favorite things about it is this thing right here, where you take out your building, and look, your little toolbox is on the left hand side. That's pretty neat, I think. Normally it's down below, but this kind of is a little bit more realistic to the way that he looks when he's moving his buildings in third person. So but as far as this round goes, you know what, let's try the shotgun, and we'll go for the short circuit here. We'll play level 3s on offense. It works pretty well when you're building near the cart. Oh, there's a sniper just kind of looking at us. Not really scoped at all. I'm very confused. Is he trying to no-scope us with the op? This isn't CSGO, buddy! Heavy is right there. I'm gonna be a little bit more passive about this gun. Hey, buddy. Uh-oh. I don't have any more metal. Good thing that scout was distracting him for that second, though. There we go. Oh, there's metal here. See, they changed a few things about the packs here since the last time it updated. I should be used to them by now, but for some reason I am not yet used to them. There we go. I'm gonna keep it at level 2 for a little bit here, because I want to start moving it more aggressively. Oh, there's a level 3 over there. I heard it, but I didn't know that it was that out there. Alright, we're back in it. And, you know, I want to comment a little bit more on my thought processes. I realized that I should probably do that a bit more. Oh no, Suicide Pyro. Take care of him. He's not dead yet. He's not dead yet. He survived for way too long there. You know what, let's build the dispenser, because I think we might be holding this for a little bit longer, since I hear there's sentries around the corner. Generally, I only build dispensers when I can tell that we're going to be holding a choke point and things like that, so... I feel like this is a spy. It is. I'm probably dead rang, though. So I don't think he took that much damage. But this gun is kind of nice here because it's making it so our team can peek around this corner. That spy also dead rang here. I'm going to go and meet him. Looks like he was already met by this scout over here. Thanks, Pyro, for making it a little easier to engage on that guy. What did I take 100 damage from? It was probably a rocket. He direct-hitted me. Alright, we're going to move this a little bit more up. Gotta be aggressive with your gun placements, and you gotta know when to do it too. Because I mean, some people try and move things up when there's a lot of stuff going down. Basically, it's not a good idea because you'll get sniped. Here, for instance, I'm moving this gun right here because I saw that the sniper that was peeking that corner got killed. I saw the kill feed. Oh no, I got stabbed. So yeah, that is a little bit of a mistake on my part. I should have been looking behind me, but we Ubered in. So I think that we did well enough. What happened to my teleporter entrance? Gonna move this up as well. The sniper? Oh, that spy is wrecking havoc. Oh no, he's got the thing that makes it so that you get crits every time you stab somebody or sap buildings or do anything as spy, really. It's free crits gun. So. And, you know, we've got a couple statues in spawn, as per the usual. It wouldn't be TF2 without it. So, we're gonna have to go back to being passive again, I guess. Because they took the ground that we had hardly worked for, really. I mean, this team isn't exactly the most aggressive. But that's okay. Because we're playing defense on offense here with this level 3 setup. So now that's level 2, I think we can start moving it up. My team looks a little brave here. Ooh, surfing a little bit off of that. Now we're gonna try and take these stickies out while my gun builds. Oh, I must have missed some other stickies there. I didn't think that they were close enough to take down a level 2 in one hit. But then again, Demoman is the most powerful class ever, right? At least when it comes to engineers. This guy's just spamming those stickies. I'm just playing whack-a-mole with these stickies here. Oh man, I didn't know there were that many people around the corner. I would have directed my aim at them instead of useless stickies on the ground. I don't know if we're far enough up to really warrant putting the teleporter exit up, but since we have our metal and we've got full metal in our dispenser now, might be able to pull it off. Oh, that was probably a bad idea to move that sentry gun at that time, but this seemed to have worked out, I guess. Now we're gonna try this here. This might actually be a bad idea. Because when they come out of the teleporter, they might come right into the... Oh, my gun just started betraying me there for a second. I also can't seem to hit anything. There we go. Being an engineer main, I never learned how to aim. These fancy buildings do it pretty well for me. You know, I wish I had my, you know, we're gonna, oh, you know what, actually, I think this is a better idea, since I just noticed that they have three people alive. I'm gonna move my sentry gun right here and try and spawn camp them. And we're Ubering at the same time. This is actually really good. Awesome. Push the cart, boys. Get that medic. Aw, yeah. Haven't really been using the short circuit a whole lot, but I also haven't really noticed a whole lot of people firing, like, rockets and stuff at me. I just saw a blood spatter come out of midair there, so I know that the spy crossed over. I don't know where he is, though. Try and look out. I thought that pyro was him. He was looking at them backs all hungry-like. Oh, there's a gun here. Hopefully they don't notice me. Okay. It's up. I also like using the Rescue Ranger with this, because then I can move my gun faster. Like, say we move the cart to, like, down there, and say my gun had a clear view of the had a clear view of the cart. King Raja is asking me if I can do some voice lines for his video right now. Not right now, man. I'm making a video. And you just became a guest star. Looks like we're moving it along pretty nicely here, actually. And like I said, Rescue Ranger would have been great there because basically when you're near the cart, you can Rescue Ranger things for free since you get your metal back pretty much instantly. Oh, this guy's flanking. He's a flankman. You're not gonna get away. You're not gonna get away, sir. I will chase you, and I will die to a crit. As it happens in TF2, that's just the way it is, I guess. I don't know what to say when I get killed by a crit most of the time. It's like, well, if you didn't want to get killed by random crits, you shouldn't have played the game. Maybe someday they'll reconsider the mechanic of random crits in pubs. Okay. You know what? Sure. Well, you heard it here first, folks. The best way to kill a spy is to high-five him. It seems to be an insta-kill every time. You know what? A smarter Dane would have shot the engineer in that situation because it was pretty obvious that that soldier was already shooting the gun. But it worked out. It's not like it really mattered. But then again, when you look at... I think that when you play, especially if you're at the point in your game where you feel like you have everything under control most of the time, I think that you can be pretty self-analyzing. At least I try to be. In the moment, most of the time, I'm thinking to myself, I could have done this better. And then, you know, next time, you'll be more aware of your mistake before you make it, and then you won't make mistakes as much. Instead, you'll make different mistakes. I probably should be using the JAG for this, but I was talking about something, and I guess it just slipped my mind. See, you know, that's a good example. See, right there. I was talking about how I should be more critical of my mistakes, and immediately during that, I was making a mistake, and then I was instantly critical of it. Last time I played on this map, I put the teleporter, up here, but the map maker kind of noticed that that was a popular spot. It used to be a little bit more indented back here, so you couldn't really see it as much, so, he changed that, which I think is for the better, because now you can put it up here, but it's a lot more, it's a lot more visible. Sorry, I just had a quesadilla. It's a pretty good quesadilla, especially the second time around when it came back up. But live commentary is, when you're playing defense, NG, probably the most fun thing to comment on. So I guess we'll just talk more about these animations. The animations, they're pretty nice. I like them a lot. And I really do wish that Valve would see these and add them to the game, because I mean, like, what's the hurt? What do you... I don't even know what to think about some things that I see in public servers. There are a few things that I'll show you a little bit more of in a second. I need some metal if I want to be healing my sentry, Dane. Like, for instance, this, as you can see, the Wrangler, whenever I use the Wrangler, it goes through it. But I think it's mostly just because I'm using the skin of the Wrangler, not the actual Wrangler. The Wrangler works fine, I think. But, you know, this is a relatively new skin, or a relatively new animation pack, so I'm sure it'll get updated eventually. There's also another glitch that I'll show you. Actually, I might as well just do it right now, since a whole lot's going on and spawn is right here. We'll switch to the JAG and be more aggressive, because that's more fun to watch. As you can see, I've been collecting the pistol skins. What pistol do I use? I'll use my strange one, the brain candy pistol. The animations, like the inspect animations, are a little bit different. not really too noticeable, but the pistol animation, I've noticed he doesn't take the clip out, which is kind of important, I think, for the pistol skins, because on the clip, there's usually a sticker. Like, for instance, on this sticker, I have a rainbow, and I want to see my rainbow. But I guess he didn't include that in the animation, so. But maybe someday. Ooh, this guy's being brave. Let's help him out. Here, let's be more brave. Let's have a brave contest. See, you shouldn't have been brave. Now you're getting demo knighted. And now you lost your thing. Oh, he took so much damage. I thought he was more hurt than that. He was running towards a health pack, and I assumed when somebody runs towards a health pack that they're hurt. Alright, now that that's healed, I'm gonna try and take care of my engineer who's being just as brave. Or should I? I think I should probably go and attempt to, no. I should have probably realized that that wasn't gonna happen. I was too far away from the beginning. I took out my secondary there thinking that I had the short circuit and I would be able to just insta find him, but he decloaked, so it worked out. Things just sometimes work out, you know. So, but I think that I'm getting pretty lucky. This pub seems to be going quite well. For instance, getting random crits for absolutely no reason. Oh. Oh my god. I can't believe you would do that to me, Sentry. I built you, and what do? You destroy me. You know what? Let's do something fun. Let's switch to the Frontier Justice here. Hopefully in the next 5 seconds, my sentry gun doesn't magically go down for no reason. Because we're going to get 21 crits. And let's see if we can land all 21 crits in 15 seconds. I highly doubt that we're going to be able to. Alright, let's go! Where are ya? Die, everybody, die! Oh, well. I still have 15 left. Oh well. Alright, one more round here. I'll show off some weapon animations that I don't normally use. I'm not a huge user of the Pompson. I don't really use it very often. And I don't really use the Southern Hospitality very much. So this is an episode of using weapons Dane doesn't normally use. I'll explain why I don't use these. I don't really use the Frontier, I don't really use the Southern Hospitality very much because I feel like random crits in pubs is really important on Engineer, because Engineer has a pretty high chance of getting random crits on his melee weapon because, I don't know if you guys know how crits work, but, or random crits, you get them based on how much damage you did in the last 20 seconds. So if you're doing a lot of damage, it increases your chance for a random crit. It's basically like a win more situation. I'm not really sure why that works. I actually disagree very heartily with how that is set up, but that's just how it works. So the more damage you're doing in the span of 20 seconds increases your chance for a random crit. So Engineer does a lot of damage, and it counts. His sentry gun counts. So, yeah. The Southern Hospitality, of course, you know, doesn't get random crits. It does do a little bit more damage with the bleed effect, but for the most part, it's better to kill someone instantly than to take time to kill them. And as for the Pompson, I don't use it because, well, I don't like using it. I just don't feel like it's fair. I don't like the mechanic of removing Uber at all, and I boycott it in that sense. But also, I don't know, I'm not used to the way the projectile feels. I'm sure that I could probably get better with it if I tried to, but I don't know. I personally think that it like, a weapon for the Engineer that, like, penetrates targets, like it used to, because it used to penetrate targets kind of like how the Bison does now, but they patched it because it was too overpowered. I mean, like, it had the ability to remove Uber, and it had the ability to remove Cloak from a Spy, and you can, and it penetrates targets. So they removed the penetrates targets, Eventually, they made it so that the distance that it travels affects how much Uber and how much of the Spice Cloak it removes. I'm gonna die here. They pushed on us like they were bullies. You know how bullies push people. I don't know. Couldn't really think of a good very good analogy for that. But the Pompson, I think, would be better if they just removed the spy removal thing, the Uber removal thing, just remove those, and then make it so that it penetrates players again. That would be fine. I think that would be interesting enough because you can use it in certain situations where, like, say, people are lined up, and you can, like, crits an engineer, and then, oh, hell yeah. See, look, that medic just lost 20 Uber. 20% Uber for no reason, because I wasn't even aiming at him. He just happened to walk in front of my beam, and I can't aim, and I can't spy check. And then I guess we can talk about the short circuit. I used to never use it because I don't know, I felt kind of the same way about it because I have always kind of known the short circuit to be one of those dick weapons to use when you want to be big dick. But I didn't use it very much after they kind of nerfed it. I haven't been building anything. I need to build stuff more, man. And I kind of went back to try and use it after they unbanned it in UGC. And, you know, it's a lot of fun. In fact, so much fun that I didn't use it in that prime situation where I could have. In fact, I should... You know, right when I take it out, the heavy peaks around the corner here. But I'll try and be more engineer-like here, alright? I'll try and build more buildings. I think that's the main thing I'm doing wrong in this situation. I am so very caught out, and I'm scared, and I want my mom. Excuse me. There, now he's bleeding. And now I'm dead. Because I focused a battle medic over everything else. But maybe we'll end on a lose here, because I'm not able to carry with my OP weapon loadouts that I'm used to. So I'm gonna start opening up this flank for people, because a lot of people kind of forget this is here, except for this guy. This guy's actually doing pretty well with it. But we'll help him out. We'll bring the flow of traffic in this direction. The cool thing about engineer is, like, if your team's bad, you can kind of try to make them better by influencing them by placing buildings in certain ways, like this will influence people to walk in this direction like they're supposed to be doing. Alright, I think we killed most of them, somehow. I didn't actually contribute to that at all, because they pushed the main area pretty well. Uh-oh, I'm being shot at. Please help. Okay. This guy is dead now. Okay. I was gonna go up here and murder the sniper, but he's dead now. My team's doing quite well without me. I feel like I'm being pretty useless here. Oh well. We'll build this here. Hopefully no one sees me. I think they can see me through the... Uh-oh. Uh-oh. I feel like I could be doing a lot more damage if I knew how to actually aim this weapon. I don't. I really don't. I think that it takes a little bit of getting used to. But I would definitely be more inclined to use it if it wasn't such a kind of a jerkish weapon to use, you know what I mean? Like, I could totally kill this pyro pretty easily if I had a hit scan weapon, but I can't seem to hit him, and this seems like a bad idea. So I'm gonna build this kind of far back here and then move it onto the crate. Yeah, there we go. I need health. Now need even more health than I needed before. What do I do? What do you do when you have 29 health? You peek a choke, Dane. That's what you do. Let's see if this medic will heal me. See, I definitely could have hit that spy if I had a hit scan weapon. Oh well. Oh, but my sentry will just take care of him. Sorry, Jose Airbuilder 123. That is a name if I ever saw one. The best Steam names are the ones that are obviously like their username, the one that they log in with because they haven't figured out how to change their name yet. Let's shoot this sentry though. There we go. Oh, I got the sentry. I like how the kill icon is like a dude getting killed even whenever I shoot the sentry gun. Let's do a little bit of a flank maneuver here. I don't know if this is gonna work. I'm gonna flank along with the, oh, this is a bad idea though. There we go. Worked out. It all works out in the end. See, that would have been a cool moment for it to penetrate because it would have hit those dudes behind the pyro as well. Alright. Surprise, guys, we're in this area now. I can't seem to jump over it. Nope! I'm one health. Thank you. Oh! Nah, it's too late. It was too late, and he got his sweet, sweet revenge on me. But then my sentry picks up the kill, and then my sentry gets sapped immediately. I'm practicing my monster truck announcement voice. I recently got a second job being a monster truck announcer. I'm not really sure why they approached me for it, because I'm a big redheaded nerd with glasses, and they're like, you look like the kind of guy that would do a monster truck voice. And I was like, you betcha. I was ready to go out there and just start denying that demo man of using any of his weapons. And then the pyro's like, no, actually, you can't do that today. But we will win this round. If it's the last thing I do. So yeah, I feel like it's so, you need to be able to predict before it happens. Because the time it takes to take out the short circuit, it seems, but this is the nice thing about the short circuit. That's my favorite part. That's what made me start using it a lot more, because spies hate it, and NGs love it. It's great, man. It basically makes it so that cloaking is not an option if the engineer has metal. Uh-oh. Sentry gun. You know, sane sentry gun is how you build it. Sentry gun. Go gadget, sentry gun. Okay, I'm just gonna do this. Okay, that didn't work. As well as I hoped it would. Uh-oh. I don't have enough to delete those. Actually, I do, it's 15. What are you talking about, Dane? Of course you do. For some reason, I thought it was 25. This medic is a hero for using the amputator correctly. That's a pretty good idea. Uh-oh. Oh, this guy's going for it. He wants the kills. He wants those jumping off the cliff kills. Or, you know, forcing us to jump. I think we're gonna win. Yeah, we've got an Uber at spawn. Nice job. And we sacrifice our bodies to the alien overlords, as usual, and, that's how it happens. Oh, man. Great game. But thank you guys for watching. Oh, and the map ends and everything. I hope that you guys enjoyed. And if you want the animations, you can check down in the description. They're pretty easy to install. Here's how you do it. It's easy. You see these things? You see this thing? Oh, no. See this thing? You open it in WinRAR. WinRAR is free, okay? You open it in WinRAR, and then you open your TF folder. If you don't know where your TF folder is, just follow this thing here. Program files, Steam, Steam apps, common, Team Fortress 2, TF, and then go to custom. And then you're gonna wanna copy and paste these into here. And I already have them in there, so I'm just gonna move and replace, sure. And there you go, that's all you gotta do. If you have a custom folder that has the folder skins in it already, some people have that, then you put it in the skins folder. But if not, if it just looks like this, where it's just maybe your HUD and then, you know, workshop maybe, and then I have stuff for like my hit sound, then that's all you gotta do. It's that simple. If that doesn't work, please don't ask me. I don't know how to troubleshoot this. I just found this on Game Banana, and I made a video about it because that's how you make videos on YouTube. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. I will talk to you nieces and nephews next time. Bye-bye.